Welcome back. In this video, we're going to be talking about writing tests with UI commands. So interacting with the user interface, things like clicking, typing, checking checkboxes, all the things that make Cypress truly magical. So in this video, the learning goals are as follows: to understand how to write tests that interact with the user interface, and then to recognize when to use command options. So we'll go over a variety of different commands and then some situations where you'll want to pass in some options depending on certain use cases for your tests. So let's go ahead and jump into the code. So I know I said we're going to jump into the code, but as I like to do, pointing out the documentation for this. So on Cypress's website, there's not a dedicated like commands link or page, but their API does have a list of all of the commands that are available through Cypress and lots of really good examples. So like we're going to go over click as one of our examples, and we'll do a couple of different things, but this really dives super deeply into all of the options and arguments and examples and all that stuff for just click. And they have pages dedicated to each of these actions. So would again encourage you to take a look whenever you've got a chance. So if we flip back over to our test, I've got Cypress open, that command running. I've also got the project running. It's running locally on localhost 8080. We have our most recent two tests. We can go ahead and comment these out. And let's start a new one. So we can say that it links to the actions page correctly. And then from here, we can cy.visit the homepage. We can cy.find all by text. And we'll look for actions. And then we're going to find the last one and click it. The reason we're doing this, find all by text actions, is because we know our project, and we know that that project has a top level navigation with drop down items, and one of those drop down menu options has an unordered list that when you click on it, it'll open up the sub navigation. That element there is a link to this actions page with this text of actions. That one is hidden, and that would actually be the first one. We'll go over this in the actual example here in a second. But that's the first one in that top level navigation. The last one is the one that actually shows up in the body, and that's the one that we want to click. So once we find that, we can actually test the URL that appears. So this presumably should, if we click on it, it should link us to this actions page. So we can check the URL by using this cy.url command. And then we should say, we can assert that it includes commands/actions. We could do equals and then the full URL. But in this case, we assume that the prefix of the URL, the localhost 8080, is going to exist, and we just want to make sure that we're linking to the correct route here. So we can go ahead and save this and pull up our test runner and restart. So finding all by text actions, we grab the last one, which you can see highlighted here in the body with actions. We click on it. And it's kind of nice, they show you that little red dot up there that's like, hey, we're clicking on this. And then we went to the new URL after the page loaded. We checked our URL and expected it to be commands/actions. So I mentioned here the find all by text actions, and we grabbed the last one. The other one is actually up here in commands actions. So that's the other actions that's actually hidden. But let's take a look if we had done first. Find all by text actions first, click. We switch back over. It's looking, and it couldn't find one. this element A, an anchor tag, is not visible because its parent on order list drawdown menu has CSS property display none. So basically what's happening here is we have this navigation, but the UI like thinks that that link doesn't exist. So Cypress is crawling through our code and it knows like, hey, there is actions here, but the user wouldn't know that without clicking on commands. So when we click on commands, now you can see this unordered list. It no longer has the display none property on it. And from there, you could click on actions. So there's a couple of things we could do. We could try and find, you know, find all by text commands first, click on that, and then find all by text actions, click on that. The other option that we could do is pass in an option to our click command. And so what that would look like is we have find all by text actions first. It is finding the first one, but it can't click on it because it's technically hidden from view. So what we can do instead is we can do force true. And so force true allows this action to be taken, assuming that that Cypress found something in the UI. So if we flip over now, oh, I put force true in first instead of click, my mistake. So force inside of click, and now that works. So we found the first one and we clicked it. So you'll notice that it's not even showing up in the UI, but it finds the first one. And if you were to click on this first and inspect in the console, you can see that there's two anchor tags that are showing up and we're grabbing that first one. And this is what it yielded. There's one element. So again, it's nice of Cypress to provide this level of detail and insight into your different elements. So that's one option there. And as I mentioned, we could have written a longer test, but in this case, it's more concise to just do force true. All right, so let's do some more UI commands. So we can do it lets you type in an input field. We've seen an example of this before, but let's go over another one. So we can do cy.visit/commands/actions. We'll do cy.find by placeholder text. And again, this is only going to work, this find by placeholder text and find all by text, if you have the Cypress Testing Library plugin installed. So if you haven't watched that video, go ahead and take a look. It's posted. And we'll walk you through how to set up that specific plugin for this project. So find by placeholder text, we're looking for one with the placeholder text of email. And then we'll type in there, we'll say test. And to assert something, we can chain on dot should have value test. So let's refresh this. So it lets you type in an input field. We went to commands actions. We found by placeholder text email, which you can see highlighted in the top right there. We typed out test, and then we expected it to have the value of test, which it did. If you wanted to type in this disabled text area, if you tried to, it wouldn't work initially, but you could, of course, use that force option that we just took a look at. All right, next, it lets you clear an input field. So you can manually clear out your input fields with this clear command. So we'll go ahead and visit that same page. We'll copy this. We'll do cy.findByLabelText. We'll do describe with a colon. We're going to do type test description. We'll say it should have a value. Of test description, and we can copy this just to make sure that we didn't do a typo. You can of course put these in variables if you want to be extra safe. So should have value test description. We'll do a new line and we'll do dot clear, and then we'll chain on dot should have value of an empty string. So this is all chained together. I just put on a new line for readability. So we're going to find by label text describe. We're going to type into that input test description. And then we're going to check to see if it has the value of test description. Then we're going to use this clear command. So we'll chain that on to the same line. And we'll make sure that it has a value of an empty string. So we'll restart this, let you clear an input field. So we visited commands actions, found describe, which is here. We typed in test description, which you can now see in the top right, when we expected it to have that value. We then cleared it, and now you can see it went from test description up there to now empty, and then we expected it to have a value of an empty string, which it does. Next, let's look at checkboxes. So it lets you check a checkbox. So we'll visit our commands actions. And then we'll cy.get. So this we're going to use just the regular get. And if we look in actions, so here's our checkbox section. We can see that it has a class of action checkboxes, and there's an input type of checkbox. So we'll use that information to grab the checkbox that we want. So we'll cy.get.actionCheckboxes, where the type equals checkbox. We'll grab the first one and we'll check it, and then we'll say that it should be checked. So this is the equivalent of the have value. We've got it built in where it should be checked or not. So taking a look at this one that just ran. So it lets you check a checkbox. We visited, we got the actions checkboxes, and you can see all three of those checkboxes are highlighted in the top right. Then we grab the first one, which you can see highlighted in blue. We checked it, so it shows you that little red dot where it's actually clicking it, and then we expected the input to be checked, which is true. So if we did the second one, where the index equals 1, so this is our second item, you might notice that it was disabled. And so we run into that same issue. So what we can do here is we can once again pass in that force true. And now, even though it's disabled, we can click on it and we can expect it to be checked, which you can see here, the UI, it shows that it's disabled, but we still see that it's checked. So those are just a couple of examples of the UI actions that you can take. So clicking, typing, checking, you can double click, you can right click. Again, Cypress does a wonderful job of showing all of these examples and their options and different ways of implementing these commands on their documentation section. So be sure to check that out when you're writing your own tests. In the next video, we'll build even further upon this by taking a look at some similarities and differences between Cypress and jQuery. So we'll be able to leverage some jQuery-like syntax in writing our tests and accessing different DOM elements. So be sure to come back for that video. In the meantime, be sure to check out our blog page at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our community page at community.lambdatest.com for more information about testing and getting certified as a Cypress testing specialist. So that's it for this time. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you next time.